The NGOs argue that prisoners, especially those on 5 or more years sentences, should be allowed to vote, insisting that being a prisoner does not take away their voting right.
For Kenya, how elections were done, the different aspects, the good practices that have been borrowed from Kenya, and they also being done here, which are applicable.
The reforms were presented during a meeting with different stakeholders that included leaders from districts of Kabarole, Fort Poto, Bunyangabu, Human Rights Commission, police officers, among others. Under the same reforms, NGOs also want the number of members of parliament to be reduced, insisting that there are many and expensive to manage their operations.
On the appointment of the Electoral Commission top 40 members, reducing the number of members of parliament, raising the academic qualification for district councillors and members of parliament. Elections start with lower urban local government. Lower urban, now for us we start with local government, so those which are urban and non-urban, and then followed by parliamentary, and then again with presidential.
They also want the academic qualifications for district councillors raised to Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education, while those of members of parliament raised to bachelor's level.
Many election petitions come in court because of the minimum qualification. The minimum qualification we have set as a standard to be a member of parliament is A level. Now, A level is okay. That is advanced level. But the lawmakers went and added something, or it's equivalent.
Early this month, the Electoral Commission announced that it had tabled several electoral reforms to Parliament, which amongst them included Ugandans in diaspora and prisoners to be allowed to vote. However, Baina Robert, the regional election officer, Midwestern, says the implementation will come with a number of challenges.
For us to transmit results, whether they are faulty or not, this will help my leader, Uganda, in the polling station. And they also say any complaint arising at that time, you can only sort it out now in a petition, but the Kenyans have time to handle complaints. They have a process called collating.
However, there were concerns that Ugandans are not always educated on electoral reforms and processes, and this leaves many ignorant about their rights. Cora Kahwa, the Uganda human rights officer in charge of civic education, however, noted a lot of information has been available, but many people are reluctant to research about it.
All goes back to us, the mindset change. Much as you're carrying out this research and all these things, these government programs, people shun them.
The participants of the meeting also expressed displeasure at the unfairness shown during the campaigns and called for an end of violation of human rights. Report by Janantu Singwire for the news.